go see the doctor.
Here goes the neighborhood. Here goes the neighborhood. Here goes the neighborhood. Here goes the neighborhood.
This is Nicholas Lindsay. Nicholas is about to be interrogated by the police because they believe he shot and killed a police officer in St. Petersburg, Florida. On February 21st, 2011, Officer David Crawford responded to a 911 call about a suspicious person walking around in the middle of the night. When the officer arrived, he would be shot and killed at close range by the suspicious person. Upon receiving tips from the community, the police raided Nicholas's home and brought him in for interrogation. Because he was under the age of 18, Nicholas was allowed to have his parents in the interrogation room with him.
Tell me I'm not doing
it. Who did it? Nicholas, listen to me. Listen to me.
Son, don't do that, son. Right now, this is very serious.
Don't tell us. Okay, listen to me.
Okay, son. Okay.
It's okay, son. It's okay, son. I know, baby. It's okay.
So this going to be okay, son.
It's
going to
be all right, baby.
It's going to be okay, son. I don't want you to go.
This is what I'm doing. This is what I'm doing. I've been talking to you all day, right?
Yeah.
Okay, baby. It's okay. Just tell us what happened.
I don't know.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. This is me. This is me. It's like we heard. Everybody in the family was heard. Tell us.
I don't know.
What happened?
I don't know.
Tell us what
happened. I was not there. I'm telling you, I was not there.
Those are your shoes. Okay. No, those are your shoes.
Yeah, oh my God.
Listen, you got to tell the truth, son.
We're right here.
I was not there.
Those are your shoes, Nicholas.
Yeah.
Those are your shoes. Stop.
Nicholas, if you didn't do it, you was with somebody that did this, son.
I did not do it. That was not there.
Yes, she was. Yes, she was.
Oh, my God.
Yes, she was. Yes, she was.
Oh, boy.
Nicholas, don't do that. See, when you do that, you want to get like this? This how you want to do it?
I love you,
man,
son.
I'm telling you, I'm
but
not
doing
it.
How do your shoes get down, son? How do your shoes get down?
Listen to me.
These please tell us, son. They got evidence, son.
You got evidence.
We can't save it, son. If you want to come home, you want to come home. Do you want to come home?
Yes.
You need to talk to these people.
Was it an accident?
I told them, man, I was not there.
Yes, she was.
Honestly. Honestly, I was not.
Nicholas.
Whatever, man. I'm down.
Okay.
They're taking me, let me just take it.
I love you.
I love you. With all my heart.
I love you.
There's a video.
There
was a camera that caught the picture.
And what? You.
Of you.
Walking down the sidewalk and in the grass, cutting through somebody's grass.
There's a video. No more lying, son.
Tell no more lying, son. Happened. You got to.
We right here.
You got to tell us
it
the truth, son.
It does not matter. We here all the way. Okay. The video.
Son, we can't save you. We can't. They got evidence to keep you.
They got DNA.
Well, who is it?
I gave them shoes away.
Okay, but that's not the point. On the video. On the video. We're not coming in here with some.
So what they're going to take me to jail?
Yep, they're going to charge you. But that's why we're giving you.
What?
The suicide of a police officer.
Fuck, man!
And you were not.
I was not done.
Nicholas's parents don't believe their son was a shooter, but they do believe that he knows who the shooter was. What they don't know is that he has been trying to become a member of a local gang that has a reputation for being extremely violent. On top of that, they have other evidence including video footage of him in the area around the time the shooting took place.
We're not coming down on you. I'm not going to change nothing about how I feel. You're going to always be my son.
We love you. I'm here with you.
I'm here to help you go through this.
Right. We're going to be with you all the way, son. We're not turning our back on you.
I have a loyal son for myself, but if you did not pull that trigger, you need to tell us let the officer
know. But we know you were there.
They probably
the number one. We probably the number one snitches in the whole old car. I dealt with more snitches with money, more snitches don't got no money, more snitches. You act like you didn't tell. You just really want to come back around and just hang out. It's only one snitch that I respected from 9-0. He know he told in a major case, in a major way, and he left and he never came back. Out of all the snitches ever on my watch from 9-0, that one, he flew away and he never came back. I respect him the most because he was one of our best. He was a grinder. He was a shooter. He was all that. But once he crossed over that line, he knew it's time for me to go. Ain't never had no problems with him. But all these other dudes, the ones that don't like me, the ones that they say probably had me shot, the ones who still want to be in control or whatever, I have to deal with them for years, many years. And of course, I'm only talking about the ones I don't like. My whole 9-0 career is based on dealing with the snitches. And the homies who got money, some of them ain't snitches. But you think you could just do what you want to do. Them was the only people I ever had problems with. Then this dude pop up and shoot you 6 times. That's crazy. But what they gonna do when that police station get you and you gotta sit in that room and it's cold and you done already messed up? The police already know you scared. They already know you finna tell. It's just a matter of time. What go through their mind when they shaking like a crap game? And still get time after you been told you want to come back to the hood. You want to show people paperwork. Here go page one. Then it's page three. Well, what happened to page two? Then it go to page five. Well, what happened to page four? Then it go to page nine. Well, what page 5, 6, 7, and 8? Oh, look at this. I ain't told. This dude told. This manuscript should have 48, 49 pages. Why is it only 28? Where's the other pages at? I didn't read paperwork that said suspect gets up to go talk to his girlfriend in the holding in the other interrogation room because she wasn't cooperating. He didn't already told. He didn't already told because he got caught doing something stupid. And now he wants to go tell on everybody else. The homies then got away. They at the second location counting money from a bank robbery. This goofy gets caught all by himself. Don't have nothing to do with nothing. You didn't follow your plan or something. But now you caught and you telling. And he with his girlfriend. She's staying down. She's not cooperating. She ain't answering no questions. He done told the story from beginning to A, who done did what, where they at the second location in the whole nine. They said, look, man, we want to believe you and all that, but your girl in there, she ain't cooperating your story. She not telling us. For real? That's what he say. For real? Man, let me go talk to her. Let me go talk to her, man. Let me tell her. Let me holler at her. They get him up and let him go into the other interrogation room and say, bitch, you better start telling them the truth. Tell the niggas what really happened. Fuck these niggas, this and that. So she start telling. Imagine that. Then you do 20 years still, get out of jail, and want to come back around to the hood like ain't nothing never happened. What's up? These dudes are crazy, man. Listen, I never had a problem with this dude. I know about the whole case and everything. I ain't saying nothing to you when you got out or nothing. But because I made a simple Facebook statement on somebody else's page that made a comment about homies coming to the hood, this and that, whoop de whoop. And I put on my homie who's solid, Baby Cool Joe, I put on his page, on his question, I said, Cool Joe, if they can't come to, I got a rule. I got so many rules from 9-0. If you can't come to the park or the hood by yourself without nobody and answer any questions, it must not be meant for you to come. Because you know what niggas start doing when they wrong? Hey, what's up? Hey, meet me in the hood, cuz. Hey, what's up, cuz? Meet me in the hood. Hey, man, you heard what that nigga said about me? Hey, whoa. Hey, man, cuz over here talking foul about you, homie. Whoa, you need to pull up. Yeah, I know, man. I'm on the phone with the homies right now. Why are you not just coming yourself? Why are you calling your homies to come against your own homies? Because cliques and crews now rule the gangs. For example, ain't no 92nd Street, ain't no 94th Street, ain't no 96th Street, ain't no 98th Street in my hood on 9-0. These are numbers that they want to write on their khakis and to look deep. You niggas don't know nobody on 92nd, 93rd, 94th, 95th, 96th, 97th, 98th, 99th. 89th, 91st, nothing. But they got that on their shirts because they want to be deep, because all y'all do is hanging apart. And they got snitches all up in there. Then already they got caught, told. Guns always come up missing. Police pull up and go right to the guns places. These snitches in these neighborhoods are gonna bring you down. They're gonna bring you down because they can't handle the pressure. Literally. I read paperwork where this nigga start crying in the police station knowing that you the person that pulled the trigger. Why are you crying? You are the person who pulled the trigger in the car. And now you're crying in the police station because this nigga got down first. Snitching is at an all-time high. If I had my way and ran paperwork on every single person from 9-0, imagine the names that I would come up with. You do it in your hood. Go hire an attorney. It's free websites also that you can go. Just get the name and run it in the system and see who come up.
Am I boring you? I'm Detective Haggerty. It's Detective Jones. I'm sure you already met him. My man. Look at this lovely cast of characters. Let me tell you something right now. These guys are in the next room over. And you know what they're doing? They're fucking singing.
Look at you. I see you sweating. Feels like the wall's closing in on you, don't it? You feel that pressure. Just drop a dime. We're right here.
We can do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way. But I need some information. And I need it right fucking now.
Snitch. 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 Snitch.
This your motherfucking conscience, nigga. Don't even do it. Don't start acting like a bitch, cause you forgot where you going. You made choices that done put you here, and now you just ruined. And I don't care about why you did it or who got you influenced. Nah, don't listen to that nigga. That ain't good advice. If you cooperate, then it's your chance to save your life. Just tell them what they wanna know, and you won't pay the price. Some will call it snitching, but for me, I call it make it right. Man, fuck that make it right shit, you gotta sit to your bed. You should've thought about this shit before you did what you did. Give a fuck about your family or your bitch or your kids. You either gon' respect the code or you gon' get what you give. Who gives a fuck about the codes? No one follow codes. We both know that jail ain't the place you wanna go. Somebody fucking on your bitch, you tryna call a phone. If I was you, I'd tell them boys everything they wanna know. Okay, let's think about this, let's embrace it. Let's make an illustration. Let's say you switch up with it and bitch up and then make a statement. Now niggas in jail, that nigga ain't tell ain't had no snitch temptations. Now you might be free, but you might get killed for giving up information. And if you don't get killed, then that's a wrap. Everybody gon' know you as a rat. Won't get no respect for the rest of your life. Nobody won't know you after that. You might get run, but you never could hide. How long you hoping that'll last? For they catch you slipping and give you something that you know you had
fuck
to have.
Fuck that, let's say you keep your mouth shut and take the blame for it. Now you need money on your books, ain't no one paying for it. No visitations or no letters you been waiting for. That pussy you been craving for. You may not get laid no more. And all them niggas that you call your brothers will be ghosts. The only one who got you is your mother if you're close. A bunch of niggas screaming free you and making posts. No one show up to your trial, niggas pray that you can smoke. Man, please tell me you ain't about to take a sucker's advice. Your kids will grow up knowing that you just a sucker for life. Lacking morals and integrity, it come with a price. And if you fold it, you should know that we ain't nothing alike. And if you leaving here tonight, you better cop a burner. Don't fuck around and be somebody ain't nobody heard of. Now here's your choice, be a man or be somebody murdered. Deceiver, you can take the stand or you be Bobby Shmurda. Free Bobby Shmurda.
Alright, man, it's me, Vic, and Rico, and C-Dot. You know what I mean? The operation was really Vic's plan. You know what I mean? He was the top dog. You know, Rico sort of ran with whatever Vic was doing, you know what I mean? I was involved in it, but I really wasn't. I really was just, you know, was told what to do. Like, I wasn't, you know what I mean? These guys was either do what they say or.
What's up now, nigga?
I want to see my lawyer.
Don't worry about it. In 2024, I'm gonna help you with your sickness. And it's going to help me with my sickness. I'm going to release the list of all the top snitches from 9-0 in 2024.
This is Dr. Crip, and we end in the sickness.
Go see the doctor.
Here goes the neighborhood. Here goes the neighborhood. Here goes the neighborhood. Here goes the neighborhood.